right? First, project management. So in this topic, what is project? A project is set of interrelated activities to be performed in a certain order to complete the entire task. So that means, for example, take construction of a building. It is a project. In that project, there are some activities. For example, first activity, plan approval, site preparation, transportation of raw materials, construction of foundation, construction of pillars, construction of walls, plastering, wiring, plumbing, and finally color. Okay, so these are activities involved in that project. Okay, right, next. So what is activity? An activity is individual operation to be executed by using time and resources. For example, in that project, construction of walls is an activity. Construction of foundation is an activity. So activity means individual operation to be executed by using time and resources. Next, event. Event or node. So this is a situation such as start or completion of an activity in the project. Okay, so that means event means it is a situation where an activity start or where an activity finish. So in the project diagram, we represent this event or node by small circle. Next, what is aim of this project management? So why we study this project management? So the aim is to minimize the total completion time of project, satisfy resource constraints. That means in the above example, construction of building. So we have to find the minimum duration subject to resource constraints. So that is aim of the project. So project management is also minimization problem. Next, what are the methods used in this topic? So there are two methods. We use CPM and PERT. What is CPM? CPM is critical path method. C for critical, P for path, M for method. Next one, PERT. P, project, E, evaluation, R, review, taking. CPM, critical path method. It is based on deterministic times. For example, construction of building, that is CPM project. So the activities require deterministic times, that is exact time to complete each activity of the project. Next, PERT. PERT is project evaluation and review taking. So this is based on probabilistic times. Probabilistic times means judgment, guessing. Okay, so this PERT is used in research projects, in some other projects. So the main difference between CPM and PERT is CPM based on deterministic times, PERT based on probabilistic times. This is main difference between CPM and PERT. So this will be given in one more question. What is difference between CPM and PERT? Or distinguish CPM and PERT. Okay, so CPM is based on deterministic times, PERT is based on probabilistic times. That is my difference. Next, so what is project network? First of all, before going to solve, we have to represent the project on a diagram. The diagram is called as network or project network. So project network is diagram used to represent project. In this network, we have different types of activities. For example, in the construction of building, consider the activities. When we start construction of foundation, after getting approval and after making the land or site to ready. So after completion of getting
plan approval and preparation of site, then only construction of foundation will start. So in that, getting plan approval and site preparation are predecessor activities of the activity foundation. Okay. So what is predecessor activity?
Activity which must be completed before one or more other activities to start.
Okay. So predecessor activity means those activities must be completed before start of another activity. That is predecessor activity. Next, what is successor activity? So reverse of predecessor activities. So successor activity means activity which starts immediately after one or more activities are completed. Okay. So that means, in that example, construction of foundation is successor activity of the activities getting plan approval and site preparation. Okay. So these are two main types of activities, predecessor activity and successor activities. Next, there is another one we used in the construction of network, dummy activity. So this consumes no time and no resources. Actually, each activity requires some time and some resources, but dummy activity requires no time and no resources. That means just like slack and surplus variables in the linear programming problem. Right. Next, we have two models to represent project. One is AON model and second one is AOA model. So we consider only AOA model. So A means activity on arc. That means each activity is represented by an arc. Okay. So these are the rules to follow in the construction of AOA network. Each activity is represented by one and only one arc or arrow. Arrow means this way. So each activity is represented by one and only one arc. Each activity must be identified by two distinct nodes or events. Node is same as event. So each activity must be identified by two distinct end nodes. Third one. Network has only one start event or node and only one final event or node. So start event means initial, final means terminal. So that means the project should start at one activity, that is one event, that is called as starting event, and should be ended at only one event, that is called as terminal event or final event. Okay, so these are the first three rules to follow in the construction of network. So consider for some examples, activity A is represented by like this. This is arc assigned with two nodes. So this node is called as tail node or tail event. This is called as head. Head node or head event. So each activity is represented by an arc accompanied with two nodes, tail node and head node. This is activity A. Second example, B, C follow A. That means after completion of A, B, C started. That means A is predecessor to B and C. So what do you draw? First draw A. This is A. That means this head event represent completion of A. From here, B starts, C starts. So this is A is predecessor of B and C. This is the way to draw this one. Third example, C follows A and B. That means C follow A and B. That means after completion of A, B, C starts. That means A, B are predecessor activities for C. So what do you draw? First write A, B. This is activity A, this is activity B. So that means this node represent completion of A and B. From here, C starts. And fourth one, consider here two parts, two segments. C follow A. C follow A. That means A is predecessor of C. D follow A, B. That means A comma B are predecessors of D.
Okay.
How do you represent this? First, C follow A. So first, that means A is predecessor of C. So this is A. Then after completion of A, C started. After completion of A and B, D fall. So right here, take here B here. This is B. So this represents completion of B. This represents completion of A. But both are completed at different nodes. So in this case, to get completion of A and B simultaneously, we have to use dummy activity. So write dummy activity in this direction. Dummy activity is represented by dashed arc. So okay, so this arc is A, it is completed here, and dummy activity. So this node represent completion of A and B. Then only D started here.
Okay.
So this is how we use dummy activity in the network diagram.
Okay.
So whenever there are two activities which are predecessor to another activity, based on the precedence relation, we have to introduce dummy activity.
Now consider another example. Consider this one. So this is activity A. A completed here. After completion of A, B started, C started. This represents completion of B and C, then D started. So, is this correct representation? Observe these two. So, what is the second rule? Each activity should be identified by two distinct end nodes. Here, B is identified by these two nodes. C is also identified by the same two nodes. So, this violates second rule. Okay. So, in this case, we have to use dummy activity. So this is wrong representation. The correct way to represent this segment is, first write activity A. So here separate, since B and C are started at same node, we have to end the activities at different nodes. Okay. So this is B, this is C. Now use dummy activity to connect these, either in this way or in this way. This is dummy activity. So from here, D starts. So this represents completion of B and dummy, that is B and C. So from here, D starts. So this is correct representation of this segment. Okay. So you can use here dummy activity either in this direction or in this direction. Or another representation. This is A. Take so both are same. But the direction of dummy activity is based on further precedence relationships. So based on those, we have to introduce this dummy activity either in this direction or in this direction. Right. So there is another rule for giving numbers to the nodes. That is Fulkerson's rule for numbering nodes. So give number 1 to start node. Now remove all arrows originating from 1. Then we get a new set of starting nodes. For this new set of starting nodes, give continuous numbers 2, 3, etc. to these new starting nodes. Continue the process until the final node is numbered. Right, consider this example. Draw AOA network to the project. So here activities from A to J. Their predecessors are given in the second row. Okay.
Right here. So A has no predecessor, that is A is independent activity. So draw
first A. So A is independent activity. So this is A. Next. After completion of A, B starts and observe further precedence relations. There is no A as predecessor in the other events. So after completion of A, B started. This is B. Next, after completion of B, C starts, D starts, E starts. That means B is predecessor of three activities, C, D, E. Okay. So, after completion of B, C started, this is C, this is D, and this is E. So, after completion of B, three activities started, C, D, E. Okay, right. Now, after completion of C, F starts, G starts. So, this is completion of C. From here, F starts, C starts. Suppose this is F. Again, this is G. Okay, right. Now, after completion of F and G, H starts. Right. How do you add H? So for H, F and G are predecessors. F and G are predecessors. But observe where the F and G are started. They started at same node. So they must be ended at different nodes. Since each activity is identified by two distinct end nodes, since F and G are started at same node, they must be ended at different nodes. So end these two activities at these two different nodes. Okay. How do you connect these two? Here use dummy activity. This is dummy activity either in this direction or in this direction. Okay. So you can write in any direction. So this is dummy activity. From here, H starts. Okay. Right. Now, next. I started after completion of DEH. So where are DEH? This is D. This is H, this is E. So all are started, right, again. So E, D are started at same node. E, D are started at same node. Okay. So they must be ended at different nodes. Okay. Suppose, right, H is started here. That means H, D are started from different nodes, so I can end these two nodes at same node. So this represents completion of D, H. Since D and H are started at different nodes, I can finish these two activities at same node. Okay, right. Now to get E. Since D, E are started at same node, these two must be ended at different nodes. Already D is ended here. I have to end E here. Okay. So this is completion of E. So how to connect completion of D, E, H simultaneously? This is D, H. So here use dummy activity in this direction. So this represents completion of E, M, T, D, H. So this is the combination of D, E, H. From here, I starts. Next, after combination of I, J starts. Okay. So all activities are added to the network. Right, now we have to give numbering. So observe what is initial event or starting event, this one. And final event is this one. So, the network should have only one starting event and final event. Okay, right. So, give for starting event 1. Now, remove arrow originating from 1. Remove this arrow. So, this is new starting event. Give it 2. Again, remove arrows originating from 2. So B, it has no incoming. So this is Next, new starting node, assign it 3. From here, remove all arrows originating from 3. Remove this. Okay. So now what are new starting events? This has incoming. So this is not new start event. This has no incoming. This has no incoming. So these two are new starting nodes. So I can give 4, 5, 2 things. So you can give either 4 here, 5 here, or 4 here, 5 here. You can give in any way. Right, next. Now again repeat same process. Remove arrows originating from 4. Remove this. Remove arrows originating from 5. Remove this. Right. Now observe. This is not new start node since it has still incoming. This has no incoming. Since it is removed, this has no incoming. Okay. So this is next to new node. Number it 5, 4, 5. Next to remove this. See 6. Remove this. So here all are removed. 7. Then 8. Then 9. So this is the way to give numbering to the nodes by using Fulkerson's rule. Right, next to CPM computations. So critical path method computations. So here we have three definitions. First, path. What is path? So this is one of the routes following some arcs from start node to final node. So starting from start node, sequence of arcs up to final node. So that is path. So there are so many paths in a project. Next, length of path. So path is sequence of activities. So length of path is sum of durations of all activities on the path. Next, critical path. So there are so many paths. Among those, what is critical path? So critical path is longest path whose length equal to duration of the project is called critical path. So what is critical path? This is longest path in the network whose length is equal to duration of the project. So that is critical path. So our aim is to find this one, critical path and duration of the project. So before going to the method, so here we have two processes. So scheduling individual activities. In this we have two processes, forward pass and backward pass. First, forward pass. In forward pass, we calculate earliest occurrence times. So what is earliest occurrence time? Suppose there is no delay in the project. Suppose there is no delay anywhere in the project, then the starting and finishing time of each activity is called earliest start time and earliest finish time, ESEF. Okay. So what is earliest start time and earliest finish time? The starting and finishing time of each activity, if no delay occurs anywhere in the project, is called earliest start time and earliest finish time. So here the assumption is there is no delay anywhere in the entire project, then the starting time and finishing time are called earliest start time and earliest finish time. So here we have some notation EI. This is earliest occurrence time of event I. ESIJ. ES of IJ. Earliest start time of activity IJ. EF of IJ. Earliest finish time of activity IJ. DIJ. Duration of activity IJ. So these are notations we use in the process. Right. Now, how do we calculate these earliest occurrence times? Okay. So we start first with start event or initial event. So for that we take E1 equal 0. Next, earliest start time of activity IJ is E value of tail event. So here I is tail event, J is head event. So E value of tail event. So ES of IJ equal EI. Next, EJ. E value of head event J.
J.
EJ equal maximum over I, EI plus DIZ. This is for all immediate predecessors, IJ of event J. So that means to calculate E value for an event J or node J, we consider the predecessors for the event J. If there is only one predecessor, we take tail event E value plus duration of that predecessor. Suppose there are more than one predecessor for event J, we take maximum of, for each predecessor, tail event E value plus its duration. We take maximum of all those values. That is easy. Next, earliest finish of activity IZ, EF of IZ equal its earliest start time ES of IZ plus DIZ. But what is ES of IZ? That is tail event E value. That is EI plus DIZ. So these are the forward calculations, that is earliest occurrence times. Right, next, another work is backward pass. So in backward pass, we calculate latest occurrence times. So what is latest occurrence time? So the latest start or finish time of an activity is the latest possible time that it can start or finish without delaying the completion of the project. Okay. So without delaying the completion of the project, as much as we can delay the start or finish of the activity. That latest possible time is called as latest occurrence time. If it is starting time, it is called as latest start time. If it is finish time, it is called as latest finish time. Okay. So the latest possible time to start or to finish an activity without delaying the completion of the project is called latest start or latest finish time. So what is the difference between earliest to start, earliest to finish, and latest start and latest finish? In the earliest occurrence times, there is a condition. Suppose there is no delay anywhere in the entire project, then the starting time and finishing time are called as earliest start and earliest finish times. So here there is no such condition in advance. Okay. So as much as we can start or finish an activity without delaying the completion of the project. So that is called latest occurrence times. So here we use this notation LJ, latest occurrence time of event J, LF of IJ, latest finish time of activity IJ, LS of IJ, latest start time of activity IJ. So these are the notations we use in this calculation. Now we calculate the latest occurrence times. So we start from final node. So in forward pass, we start with starting node, that is first node. So here we start with final node. Suppose there are n nodes. For final node, its latest value, ln equal its earliest value. Already we have calculated earliest value in the forward calculation. So for the final node, the latest value is its earliest value. So ln equal EN. So here first we find latest finish of activity. So in forward pass, first we find earliest start of activity. So earliest start of activity IJ is tail event E value. So here latest finish of activity IJ is head event L value, LJ, head event L value LJ. So this is the latest finish. Next, other tail event LI, I, LI, latest occurrence of event I is minimum of LJ minus DAC for all immediate successor activities IJ of I. So here to find latest value for an event, we consider immediate successor activities. If there is only one immediate successor activity, we take its L value as head event of successor L value, that is LJ minus its duration. Suppose there are more than one successor, we take minimum of, for each successor, we take head event L value minus duration. So we take minimum of
all these values, that is Li. Then Ls, latest start of activity Iz is latest finish of Iz minus Dij. So that is Lf of Iz is head event L value, Lj minus Dij. So this is latest start of activity Iz. So like this we calculate latest occurrence times starting from final node up to start node or initial node.
Okay, right now floats or slack. So what is float or what is slack? So it is amount of time by which an activity can be delayed without delaying duration of the project. So slack means that is amount of time by which an activity can be delayed without affecting the duration of the project. So that is slack or float. Slack of an event I is its L value minus its E value. Slack of event I is L value minus E value. Slack of activity Ij or total float of activity Ij is latest finish of activity Ij minus earliest finish of activity Ij. But what is the latest finish? Head event L value, Lj minus what is earliest finish value? Tail event E value plus duration. That is minus of Ei plus Dij, that is minus Ei minus Dij. So total float of activity Ij is head event L value Lj minus tail event I value, tail event E value Ei minus duration. That is total float. So total float means amount of time by which that activity can be delayed without affecting duration of the project. So there are two other floats, free float, independent float. First, free float means without causing any delay in its immediate successor, the amount of time by which the completion of time of any activity can be delayed. So that is called as free float. So it is given by FF of Ij equal total float minus head event slack. Here head event is J, slack of J is its L value minus E value, Lj minus Ej. So free float equal total float minus head event slack. Next, third one, independent float. It is same concept but without causing any delay in predecessors or successors, either in predecessors or either in successors, without delaying of those, the amount of time by which the completion of the activity can be delayed is called independent float. It is given by IF, independent float of activity is equal free float of activity minus tail event slack. Tail event is I, slack of I is its L value minus E value, Li minus Ea. So independent float is free float minus tail event slack value. Right, next, what is critical event? An event for which slack is zero is called critical event. So slack of event means its L value minus E value is zero. That is Li called Ei, that event is called as critical event. And critical activity, an activity for which slack is zero. So slack for an activity is EF minus ES. That is EF called ES, then that activity is called as critical activity. That's critical path. It is a sequence of critical activities from start node to final node. So critical path is sequence of critical activities. Already have given one definition in previous. Critical path is the longest path whose length is equal to duration of the project. That is one definition. Another definition is the sequence of critical activities is called critical path. So by using these
forward calculation and backward calculation. We calculate first earliest start time and earliest finish time in forward pass, and then in backward pass we calculate latest start time and latest finish time, and then find throttle float or slack, then identify critical activities, then finally we find critical path and the duration of the project. So that is the method of CPM, that is critical path method.